What's goody good? Yeah, it's your girl, Miss Geeko. You're tuned in to World of Stardom Radio. And tonight, I really have no words because I'm so excited. Because tonight, I got in the building Calvin Richardson. So, while I wait for Mr. Richardson to call in, I'm going to play one of his songs that y'all should be familiar with if y'all are fans of Calvin Richardson. And this song is called Coming Home.
It won't be long. Calvin.
Yes, and that was Calvin Richardson's Coming Home. I love that song. I really do. I see we got a call on the line. I hope this is Calvin Richardson. Let's see.
It is Calvin Richardson. How you doing?
How you doing, Calvin? Oh, I love that song, yes. Coming Home.
I appreciate that. I really do.
What's your inspiration when you write?
Well, you know, life is my inspiration. You know, it's basically about things that I've been through, things that I see, you know, on a first or secondhand basis, you know, but mostly it's, you know, basically just things that I've lived through and been through.
I love the way you write. I can relate. That Coming Home song, I can relate. You know, my dad passed, so I can relate to that Coming Home.
Oh, sorry to hear that. Yeah, you know, it's, you know, we all, you know, have lost somebody close to us in our lives, you know, and I've lost so many, you know, many people growing up with them and, you know, seeing different things when I was out in the streets, you know, there's a lot of things happening, you know, but, you know, life is a beautiful thing, you know, you have to hold on to it, the memories, and keep moving, you know?
Yes. So, are you on your own label now, or you still signed to a major label?
Nah, I've been independent for my last 3 albums.
Cause I love your Bobby Womack, your tribute to Bobby Womack. I love that whole album.
Oh, really? Thank you. I had a whole lot of fun making that album. You know, Bobby Womack is one of my biggest, you know, inspirations when it comes to, you know, the soul music. You know, soul singers.
Cause I listened to him, I said he sound like a young Bobby Womack.
A lot of people say that, but you know, when I started working on the songs, I really just kind of channeled Bobby. You know, cause there was a lot of those songs that was on the album. To be honest about it, I didn't even know those songs. There was only a couple songs that I did know that I chose to do, but I didn't want to just, you know, do all songs that I knew. So I kind of challenged myself and. You know, went in the studio, and, you know, it came out pretty good.
Because I watched his Unsung, and when they showed him singing live, I said, that's Calvin Richardson right there at a younger age. That's Calvin right there.
You know, it's great to be compared to somebody like Bobby, and people look at me and say, that's a young Bobby, or, you know what I mean, I can see myself being, you know, that respected in my older age. You know what I mean? It's something to look forward to. Hopefully I get the same amount of respect that he did, you know. A little bit of that would be good for me.
Yeah, you deserve it.
Well, you know.
You deserve it.
Yeah.
Because your 2:35 p.m. album, Don't Keep On Pushing Me, when they aired that on the radio, I said, I love this song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I would listen to it, play it over and over and over, sing along with it.
That's good. And that's, where you from?
I'm based in New Jersey.
Are you based in New Jersey? Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. I was living up in New Jersey, New York area when I made 2:35. No, sorry, when I did Country Boy.
Because I didn't know about the Country Boy album, because I think the first song was from your, that I've heard of you, was from the 2:35 p.m. album. And then when I noticed
right.
you had another album, I said, oh. And then I heard songs off of there, and I fell in love with that album, too.
Well, you know, that's normally how people come to know who I am, they'll hear something that's, you know, pretty relatively new, but it'll take them back to the older stuff, you know. And they, because of the lack of promotions on a lot of those albums, you know, a lot of people hear it, and you know, it's basically new to them. They, you know, and it's the albums go date way back to 1999, you know.
Yeah, I know. I looked at your bio online. They had a bio of you online that said what years your albums came out.
Mm-hmm.
And the song More Than a Woman, I thought that was Angie. When I heard that song, because I heard it on Angie Stone's album, and I said, oh, she did a song with Calvin Richardson. I was like, oh, this is nice.
Yeah.
Then I heard you do another interview, and you said you wrote it first, and then they added her on it. I was like, wow, I didn't know that. That's something new.
Exactly. That's actually how we met. You know, she heard the song and wanted to get on it. And so that's how it went down. But it actually, you know, we put it out on her album first before I put it out on mine, because I was recording my second album for Universal Records, and we stopped that project short in the middle of it, and they did some internal changes up there, and so that album never came out. But the guys that I was working with when we wrote that for the album, you know, she was working with them about a year or so later, and they played it for her, and you know, she tracked me down.
And she recognized the talent.
Yeah, you know that, and it's More Than a Woman. It was a great song too. It's a great song, I think, and and, you know, and like you said, she recognized that, you know, I had a little something. So we put it together, you know.
Yeah, because when I did the tribute show to you, I had people in the chat room listening, and it was like, yep, you do sound like a young Bobby Womack. And they really loved the tribute.
Yeah. On my first album, actually, that Country Boy album, I did a cover of I Wish You Didn't Trust Me So Much on there. First cover
I
ever did, and you know, and then years and years later, I just went back and did a whole album.
Yeah, I love that song too. It's like all your songs that I consider my favorites. I listen to over and over and over on my iPod.
I appreciate that. That says a lot. It means a lot.
Oh, I only play what's my favorite. You know, there's a lot of artists who I consider my favorite, and you are one of them. And I'm like, people don't know who Calvin Richardson is. I'm like, because, you know, when you mention the name, some people might say, I don't know who this person is. I'm like, you never heard his music?
Yeah.
And then when they say, oh, I heard that song, I didn't know that was him.
Exactly. You know, I had a long road of, I don't know, I think it, lack of promotions kind of hurt along the way as far as notoriety, people connecting it to the music and all that stuff. A lot of them heard the songs and stuff, but they just didn't know who it was. And, but you know, like I said, you know, I don't think I would change anything about my career. It's been good for me. I've been able to sustain myself for quite some time. Now, you know, I've been responsible for a lot of big records that came out and other people did them. So, you know, it's been good.
Yeah, and when you say you did There Goes My Baby.
Right.
I love that song. Even though Charlie's singing it, I still love that song.
It's a great song, you know. It really is a great song. Charlie did a great job with it. And, you know, I mean, the world loved that song. I mean, it went number one, and it stayed there for, you know, like 18 weeks.
So is there other songs
turned it around.
Are there other songs you have written for other artists that I may know of?
Well, I've written for Raphael Sadiq, Excuse Me, on his album. Matter of fact, I wrote like 3 songs on that album, that Instant Vintage album that he did. But it was, it was.